FedEx Field in Landover, Maryland. It's week 15 of the NFL on EA Sports. Football team taking on the Chicago Bears.
We are technically 5 miles east of Washington, D.C., and that's where you find this place, FedEx Field in Landover, Maryland. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Chicago Bears and the Washington football team. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and Charles, we look at this Washington team as they interplay here. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Bears, it's late in the year. We all know it. We've seen the calendar for these guys. Their bodies could probably use a break, but they have to push on.
And they're really not as worried about that as maybe we think. They know they've got the entire offseason to rest. All they care about is the game in front of them and finishing strong.
Second down now. It's Ward, and he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 12 yards there and a first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now a give right side. It's Ward. The numbers for him from a week ago. Charles, how do you think he ran the football?
I thought he definitely had his moments. I did think that they could have utilized him a little bit better, and I'm definitely going to keep an eye on him to see how they're going to use him this week.
Quick slant, going to be complete. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. And early on, they're picking up right where they left off last week.
And I know a lot of coaches say each game is its own. You don't really have carryover. This feels like carryover. So much confidence from the previous game that they're using to their advantage now.
On first down, Ward. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight.
Rolling to his right. He's going to take off with it. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 18. Turns out to be a great idea to tuck that one. Good for 24 yards.
Partner, it's often the man coverage is easier for a quarterback to run against. You get your receivers going downfield, those guys are staying with them, and oftentimes they have their back to the quarterback, which opens up a lot of space and room, and they don't even know that he's taking off with it. What a big-time pickup on that play.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of 3. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7.
A 3-yard pickup. Brings up.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line.
That's good.
From the 8, they've got it first and goal.
First and goal at the 8-yard line.
They'll try the left side. It's Ward. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. A loss of 2 there, second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Moved back to the 10, they'll try on second and goal here. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. A nice run there as he picks up 6. It's going to be third and goal now. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop ball right around the 5 here. Brings up third.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Able to hold him to just 2 yards, and now it's fourth and goal.
There's another example that playing football isn't strictly being physical. You've got to think as well. Nice job reading his keys by the linebacker and going out in the open space when they dumped it to the back. He was able to make the play and stop him short of the goal line.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll run for it. It's Gordon. And nowhere to go. He's going to be stopped behind the line. Gordon can't break through against this defensive line. And on the opening drive of the ball game, the defense comes up with a goal line stand. So here are the Bears backed up to start their initial drive. And leading them, Charles, their quarterback, their field general.
And I'll bet right now it's just one thought in his mind.
Win the game.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, without a doubt. He played pretty well. I mean, he didn't turn over the ball in terms of interceptions,
right? Two touchdown passes last week.
But when your team doesn't win, that's just hollow. And the best quarterbacks don't care about anything but whether or not their team won. That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
On third down, Levy, he'll get this underneath to Montgomery. And they'll mark him down right around the 9, just shy of the 10. 3 yards, all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
There's an example of good situational football being played by a defense. They understood where the third down play was, the down and distance, and made sure that they didn't get anywhere near that, bringing up fourth down.
Yeah, they were sniffing out that marker, didn't want to let him get close to there, and now a likely 3 and out to start.
Yeah, I love the way they rallied to the football and got to him and made sure he didn't give up much run after catch.
On is the punter, Scott, here as he gets this one away. So possession goes over here on the punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And it's right about this time of the year that you start to say this is when the cream rises to the top. Week 15, 3 weeks left to go, but still plenty to be determined.
It certainly is, because we all know everyone is aiming for that number one seed. But failing that, because only 2 teams in the NFL get a bye, one from each conference, that question becomes, who's hot? Who's peaking at the right time as you start the playoffs?
A gain of 3, second down.
But from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. But let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
Here's a 2nd and 7. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 15 yards on the play, first down.
an ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Out to his left. Now he'll pull it down. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
37-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
31. That's a gain of 6. Brings up 3rd and 3.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down.
No gain on the play.
I apologize in advance, partner, but the beef eaters on the interior of this D-line, you just know they were licking their chops on 3rd and short. And yes, they were rewarded with a tasty dish, stumping that one short of a 1st down.
Well, we got beef eaters licking their chops and tasty dish in one fell swoop.
I did apologize in advance, didn't I?
Yeah, you did. That line's not eating tofu, I'll tell you that much for free. So on 4th down, Ron Rivera sends out the field goal unit. From the right hash, this from 48. And his kick is absolutely perfect. And it's 3-0 Washington.
Washington 3, Bears nothing.
So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the throw.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
Chicago works their way back onto the field here for their 2nd drive of the game. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of 1st downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. A quick 1st down pickup. Good start after going 3 and out on their opening drive.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another 1st and 10. From the gun, Levy. And now he'll tuck it and run. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a 1st down.
It's a gain of 17 yards. 1st down, Bears.
Open man is Komet, the tight end. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 7 catches, 66 yards.
And you know what he did all week in preparation for this one? Hydrated.
Salivated.
Yes. Stretched. Dreamed. Going against the last team in the league against the pass.
Yeah.
He expects to catch everyone throwing today.
You're right. They have struggled 32 of 32 in that category.
Well, I would have figured after the 9-yard run on the previous play, getting one more yard wouldn't have been much of a problem. But apparently it was. And now it's 3rd down.
Come on.
from the gun on third down. Levy, he'll get that complete to his tight end, Komet. It'll be a pickup of four, good enough to earn him yet another first down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Looking to throw. Levy, that's caught by Montgomery. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. It's a pickup of 10 and a Bears first down.
It's a gain of 10. First down, Chicago.
Montgomery back to the ground. And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Brings up second and 8.
Back to throw. Levy flushed out right. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Taken down right at the line of scrimmage.
Like the footwork back there. I thought he did a pretty good job of evading that first wave of players. Tried to buy a little extra time out of the pocket, but in the end, oh, that was a tough one.
Yeah, winds up getting buried for the loss. Play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. Operating from the gun, Levy over the middle, and that's caught by Komet.
Levy's pass.
Oh, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
Well, the coverage was tight that time. They allowed the pass underneath to him, but they rallied to him pretty fast, too, converged on him and got him down. That'll bring up fourth down.
Matt Nagy has made the decision. They're going to go for it here. Looking to throw. Levy, the quick slant caught. And the Bears are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up first and goal. Dancing. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago.
Chicago.
A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Bears have taken the lead.
Well, I'd have to say that for him, that was an all-encompassing drive because it was his arm that got his team down to that point, but his legs that finished the deal. Give him credit for making it happen.
No going for two. They'll kick the point after. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. So that one a long 11-play drive. And it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. On the return, Williams. He's going to be stopped here with a penalty marker on the field. I'm not sure what this is about.
Face mask. Defense.
Don't you do it. No, I can't
go. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that would look pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
So a big penalty there on the face mask leads to first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's gonna have a first down. After one, 7-3 the score. On EA Sports.
Washington 3.
the reason we ball for. Circle round twice for the long
term.
Right back to him on first down. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
That's good.
10 yards there. Good for Washington first down. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now. And that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
It's now second and 6.
Now they run the option on second down.
The pass. He's tackled at the 32-yard line. That's a gain of 3. Brings up 3rd and 3.
On 3rd and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
The quarterback sack.
Roquan Smith in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. The wind is at his back here in the second quarter. That's on target, but it's no good. He had it online, but it came up just shy of the crossbar. And this score will stay right where it is. Now the Bears offense ready to take over again. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
From the gun, Levy. And he will find his man on the outside.
Levy's pass.
They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
4 yards on the pickup. 2nd and 6.
Operating from the gun, Levy. And he finds Montgomery complete.
Holding offense.
Now they face a 2nd and long following the holding penalty. Now Montgomery, he's got it on the draw. And he stopped immediately there.
David Montgomery, the ball carrier.
No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a 3rd and long situation coming up.
No gain on the play. And it's 3rd.
From the gun, Levy. And that will be incomplete.
As this old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out high. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Here's J.K. Scott now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. We'll call that a 47-yard punt, a return of just 3. And out will come the offense as they take over. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. And the ground game's been good, but they're losing here in the second quarter. Can they use that ground game maybe to work the air attack a little bit more?
I think so, because now you can throw play action off of being able to run the ball effectively. And oftentimes you might want to just swing your back out of the backfield and get the ball in his hands in open space. And just don't get totally away from running it, because some of these runs now, they may pop bigger as the game goes along.
Yeah, they've been good with a run so far.
Brings up 2nd and 3.
Gonna give this time to the tailback.
26-yard ball.
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A gain of 13, it's a 1st down. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled them with the inside run.
Right there.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
It's a first down on a gain of 10. Now a give right side. It's Ward, and they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
For the running back. Brought down right at the line of scrimmage.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brings up third down and 10.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Steps away. He can run for it, and he will. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 31-yard line. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure you're back. You spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. 16 yards, a first down.
First down and 10 yards to go.
Now they run from the gun with Gordon. And here he'll get it down to the 7.
Number 25.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
At the 7-yard line. A gain of 4. It's now second and 6.
They'll set up a throw. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14.
Well, nothing takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He'll get this to Ward. And he'll be tackled right on the 10, well short of the first down. He did his best to just get 4 out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? Third down. They just said, we've got faith in our tacklers. We'll give you the short stuff. And just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
And his kick here is good.
The field goal is.
And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6.
7. Washington 6.
So they put together a good little drive there, but ultimately stalling out in the red zone.
Yeah, I know a lot of people look at it as a little bit of a negative. They didn't get 6 points out of it, right? Didn't get the touchdown. But that's actually okay. They got 3 points. It will give their defense a little bit of rest, let them settle down over there. So all in all, to me, that's a good drive.
The Bears offense ready to get going again. And they're coming off a 3 and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet
and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up second and 2 at the 35-yard line.
They're going to run this with a tight end.
And boy, this burgundy and gold defense charged up now. They stop him behind the line again.
2 yards the loss, and now they go from second and 2 to a tough third and 4.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
The Bears on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 4. Operating from the gun. Levy. And a quick throw here. That's complete.
And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Third catch of this first half for him, and this one is a first down.
Oh, that was a nice job there. Quarterback and receiver reading the pressure that was brought. They both knew it was going to open up the middle of the field. Nice little shake and bake at the line of scrimmage, got right into his route. And the quarterback hit him in stride, and he was able to run free after the catch.
In Washington territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 48-yard line. From the gun, Levy is going to find his running back. It's complete. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Out of bounds at the 42-yard
line. Looking to throw on 2nd down. Levy flush to his right. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. Maybe not exactly what they had in mind, but that scramble good for 6 and a 1st down.
And the Bears.
A give to Montgomery out of the gun. And he won't get much. Maybe a couple down inside the 35 to the 34.
He's tackled at the 34-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup.
On 2nd down, Montgomery.
David Montgomery, the ball carrier.
The Bears on 3rd down, 2 for 5 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to 4th down.
A gain of a yard. It's now 4th down.
They'll pass up a field goal attempt. It would have been a 45-yarder. Now they'll go for it on 4th. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
And you're stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
They're able to keep the drive alive, 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one.
Well, the field goal attempt was well in hand. They had that, but they decided to go for it anyway. Extreme confidence, it looks like.
Yeah, but I bet the defense is going to remember this one, right? They kind of rubbed their nose in it. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked.
Chase Young
in there to get him, and that is now sack number 18 on the season for him. He was superb a week ago. 3 sacks in that affair. Now 1 here in the 2nd quarter.
How about our conversations this week? With him, it was pretty simple. He said, I've got a few combinations I can try it out they haven't seen yet. And on the flip side, they thought they had a plan to block him. Might need to come up with something else because he looks like he's getting loose now.
Punch, counter punch. So after a rare misstep on this drive, they'll try to make amends on 2nd and 15. Operating from the gun. Levy, throw left side, complete. That's Montgomery.
Levy's pass.
No yardage to speak of whatsoever. Leads to a 3rd down. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as he'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime.
throwing on third and long. Levy, it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts. As the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime.
A 43-yard attempt.
Blankenship's kick is good.
His kick is good.
And they bump the lead up to four now at 10-6.
Washington 6.
So a good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coach is always talking about finishing a drive with a kick. Two of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
Washington will take over first and 10 at their own.
A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. That's complete to Ward. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Rolling to his left, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
The quarterback.
Bilal Nichols able to take him down. It's a loss of three. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. They'll throw now on the final play. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. That's caught at the 25. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done? If you didn't know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now, he can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
Okay, Brandon, time for a sprint to the finish, as it's time to get you caught up with what's happening around the NFL here in a pivotal Week 15. We'll start over in Texas at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. And it's the Cowboys on top as they play the second quarter. Dak Prescott has thrown a touchdown pass. From there, we head up to the Pacific Northwest. Check on the Seahawks at home in Seattle. And they've got the lead over the visiting Arizona Cardinals. Russell Wilson has thrown a touchdown pass. Lastly, let's motor up to the Motor City. See what's happening with the Lions at home at Ford Field. And they were losers in that one to the visiting New York Giants. 31-24, the final score. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. So Washington in a good spot. They've got the lead. They will get the football as the second half gets underway. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25.
25-yard line.
So here's the Bears offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. We have not seen much on offense from either side. These last few drives, it has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Off the play fake. Levy on the move to his left. He'll run it. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
At the 33-yard line, it's a gain of 2 yards, and it's third down.
From the gun, Levy, and Robinson with a big catch. And he's a long ways into Washington territory before hitting the turf. A big play there on the catch and run. 56 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Operating from the gun, Levy. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Brings up second and 10.
Throwing again, Levy. Yeah, he's got it. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Darnell Mooney with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Bears have retaken the lead. Blankenship out for the point after. And that will make this a 4-point game. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. And the end result is a Bears touchdown. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Williams now on the return. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. He's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with their quarterback on the ground so much.
He'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good.
The quarterback on the scramble.
2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down.
Blacklock. A gain of 2. Brings up.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He finds his target. It's Schultz. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Washington.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. A short one going to be taken in here by Schultz. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
Brings up second and 3.
On second down, it's Ward. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45.
For Washington.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 45-yard line. He'll look to throw. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. It was Roquan Smith who got his big hand in there to knock it away.
It's now second and 10.
Being chased out left. He'll try and run it. He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down.
That's a gain of 8. Brings up third and 2.
Now a handoff here to his running back. Well, he's taken down, but not before picking up the first thanks to a flashy little spin move. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
Yeah.
line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. Moore had a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Brings up third down.
On third down, it's Ward. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
And they've got 3 tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Ward. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
On second down now, it's Ward. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sack back around the 8.
Bilal Nichols able to record his 5th sack of the season.
Defense went 3-4. They got some push from the inside.
And this is something in a 3-4 you don't normally get because the nose tackle who got the sack, he's usually responsible or ends up getting double teamed and sometimes triple teamed. How about him working his way back and putting the big guy on the ground?
So on fourth down, Ron Rivera sends out the field goal unit from the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And his kick is good. And that'll bring him back within a point.
Makes the score Bears 17, Washington 16.
He's got 9 points on field goals now. He's made 3 of them. That gets him a bit closer, but there's no question they need to start turning some of these 3s into 6s.
And for him, it's not his concern, right? He just goes out there when they call on him and goes ahead and puts points up on the board. But the offense has got to get together and figure out what's stalling their drives so they have to keep calling on him.
Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. How do you break down his game so far? Just the 1 touchdown pass, but sometimes the touchdown pass stat category, that doesn't tell the whole story.
It really doesn't, not until you bounce.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down.
A loss of 3 yards.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
Following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on second and 13. From the gun, Levy. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Give them 14 on that one and a first down.
And the Bears' first down.
Now a run with Montgomery. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Ball carrier. Tackle made at the 38-yard line.
Off play action, Levy. And he finds a man on the crossing route.
And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 9-yard line.
38-yard line.
First down, here's the run with Montgomery. And he gets it down to the 32.
Montgomery, the ball carrier.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Second and four.
They'll keep pounding here with Montgomery. And only able to get two here, stopped at the 30.
Montgomery, again, the ball carrier. Brought down at the 30-yard line.
They'll run it. Here's Montgomery. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
And they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. Made his first. This now from 46 yards away. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And they add on and get a little bit of a cushion. It's 20-16 now.
Washington 16.
So chalk that down as an 8-play drive capped with a field goal.
Yeah, as a friend of mine used to say, they were moving and grooving for a while, but they couldn't keep the momentum going enough to get a touchdown out of it.
And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
At their own 22-yard line.
And the Washington offense going back to work. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal. And I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out and out joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
And maybe wore down the other defense. Pressure, and he's taken down. A bear sack.
Quarterback sack.
And that's his second sack of the game, but this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it. He's a big-time guy you have to block.
Out of the gun now on third down. Hard throw, incomplete. And that one off the mark, a little late with the throw. Here's Tressway now, standing just about on his own goal line. So a change of possession here on the punt.
At their own 38-yard line.
Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. He's been pretty solid, pretty consistent, just the one touchdown pass, but I think he's managed the game well, no?
I would agree with you, and that's what you're looking for out of your field leader, making sure that you're playing well and not making any big mistakes. Oftentimes, that's how you're judged. Mm-hmm. How big a mistake and when it occurs. No interceptions so far. They'll like that.
I just want you to know that you agreeing with me, that's going to get me through this third and fourth quarter.
Second and three.
Are you touched?
At the 45-yard line.
He's patting his heart, boys and girls. He's touched.
Respect.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and three. Operating from the gun, Levy. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. From the gun, Levy. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field defensively. Make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open in key situations.
First down, Levy. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end.
Levy's pass.
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five at the 36-yard line.
Montgomery. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
Montgomery, the Bears ball carrier. Brought down at the 35-yard line. It's a gain of a yard.
And from the gun on third down, Levy finds his target, Montgomery. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
Yeah, they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. Going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll run on first down. It's Montgomery. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Brought down at the 23-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight.
Again, they'll go ground with Montgomery. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
And it brings up
to throw on third down. Levy, his throw caught at about the five.
Levy's
and he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown.
Chicago.
23 yards for the touchdown. And the Bears will extend their lead.
For good reason, quarterbacks want to get the ball to the perimeter to their wide receivers for big plays. But in this situation, it felt like, based on coverage, he knew that he wanted his tight end to have the football, and for good reason.
Rodrigo Blankenship on for the PAT. And that one pushes the lead up to 11. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it culminates in a touchdown for Chicago. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 20.
And as this offense makes their way back out, NFC playoff race time, we give you a look at what's going on there. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. They'll come out throwing here on first down. And with a flag down, he goes down. So they're able to sack him. Now the penalty looks like it could be holding. Let's find out. So they will take the sack instead of the penalty.
And it takes another down off the series. But the biggest one of all, do you want to tell the guy who just got the sack that it no longer counts?
No.
No, not at all.
And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 14-yard line. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. But no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there of those guys being able to run from their assignments and finish off that play.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Got his man on the comebacker. That's Grant. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores, and they've really